Well, we also have with us Shekhar Bajaj now, Bajaj Electricals. The stock has actually been an outperformer in the last couple of months. In the last month, though, it's down slightly. But there is a lot that we need to talk about with Bajaj Electricals. Their order book is fairly large, and we need to get a sense of what execution looks like as well. And of course, the bigger story, what is the GST impact on business? Morning, Shekhar. Thanks for joining in. First up, Shekhar, how is life post-GST? Is business looking good, or has it been impacted?
There were certain things which are required, certain technical thing about the stocks and transfer, all that. So that's all over. So our billing has started. And therefore, all our vendors are all, most of them are registered. So there's no problem of supply chain. And as far as dealers are concerned, from our point of view, we are ready to bill to them. Some of them have issues that will be their problem when they build. For them to get a setup and all, they need to get themselves registered. So that is there. Some of them are non-registered dealers. So from a business point of view, in the month of June, strategically, we decided not to push too much of sales on them because we did not want them to carry stocks so that they don't need to have for any adjustment or any refund or anything that. So therefore, our sale in the month of June, we consciously work wanting to control it. So therefore, knowing it, but EPC business was very good. So overall, in the month of June, in spite of consumer durable side showing negative growth, overall we've grown positively in the month of June, and for the quarter also, we've had a positive growth because the EPC business has been very good. Because order books are very good, as you mentioned just now. So I think GST is smoothing out a lot of things in terms of our business is going to be very smooth, and we are finding it, there's no issue at all.
Shekhar, there were also some reports that were doing the rounds that you were interested in Videocon's Kenstar brand. Could you clarify that for us?
See, actually, when one of the reporters asked me, there was no talk with Videocon. Even now, there's no talk with them. What actually happened was that somebody asked me that if Kenstar was available, would you be interested? So I said, of course, any good brand, who would not be interested? Somebody says, if Videocon would be available, would you be interested? Doesn't mean that Videocon has offered it to me or Kenstar has offered it to me. It was not offered to us. It was only a question which was asked, in case it's available, would you be interested? And that has been covered as if we've got the offer, we've given the offer, we've neither got any request from Videocon, nor have we given any offer. So that was just a conjecture that in case it's available, of course, anything is available. If any competitor brand is there available, are you interested? The answer is yes. We are not finalizing anything till we don't decide on the price. That's what it is. So it's nothing in that. Okay?
Shekhar, I guess journalists do have a knack of asking questions,
yeah,
right?
So it's so good. Everybody got very excited and headlines came. And I mean, frankly speaking, it was just, it was just...
You got to be a little wary before you actually answer those questions the next time. But anyway, let's talk about business going ahead, okay. Right?
If somebody says that, if a brand is available, are you interested? The answer is yes for any brand.
I agree. So let's talk about that. Then if you had to make acquisitions, is that on the radar? What is the kind of deal sizes you're looking at? This is a very open-ended question, so we won't talk about specifics in terms of names, but you can give me a sense of, you know, what are the kind of deal sizes, the kind of businesses that you'd be looking at?
The thing is that we are very much interested in acquisition, but the problem is it is never going to work out easily because... The problem is that whoever is coming in, a lot of foreign companies are coming in, like Philips bought this Preeti and this French company, the group went and bought Maharaja. They want a presence in India. And therefore, for them, a Maharaja brand is okay because they get a presence, distribution, everything ready-made set up. We don't need that. And that is our problem, that we cannot give those type of pricing, and therefore, the deals are not taking place. We are keen to buy, but when they look at the pricing, and it doesn't mathematically work out. That's our problem.
Shekhar, very lastly, you've managed to reduce your debt considerably. You tell me why? And of course, what is the reason and what's the outlook as well?
Two things are there. Number one, we've gone for channel financing where dealers are getting financed from the bank. So to that extent, our this thing to them has gone down. Our credit to them has gone down. And second is that we are very tight, that those who don't pay don't get money. If they don't pay, they don't get the material. So we've improved our working capital substantially.
Right. Thanks a ton, Mr. Bajaj. And first, good luck with business going ahead and those acquisitions that you will eventually look at. Thank you. Well, we also have JBM now. This one's been in focus in the last few days. They are, of course, one stock that's had a pretty good run in the last 5 days. The counter is up about 30.